to our presentation for this evening. You will get to witness this evening a wonderful trek through the history of the civil rights movement in America by watching the Freedom Riders. The Drama Club members have worked very hard despite our numerous interruptions and snow days to our dress rehearsal. So let's turn our attention to our opening vignette, the Snazzy Girls of He Had a Dream. Presentation of Railroad to Freedom.
Have you heard about the Underground Railroad?
It wasn't a real railroad at all. It was a safe network that led slaves to freedom.
Harriet Tubman was a slave. She ran away in 1849.
She used the Underground Railroad to get herself and other slaves to freedom.
Thank you.
wrong.
The abolitionists helped Harriet get settled in her new life.
But Harriet couldn't rest knowing her family and friends were still slaves.
Harriet Tubman became an inductor for the Underground Railroad.
The railroad was not a train at all. It was a system of boats, wagons, trains, and sink houses that took slaves from the south to the north.
Harriet risked her life to return home and help her family and many others escape from slavery.
To get 300 others, she ran for freedom 19 times to save black sisters and brothers. Harriet Tubman didn't take no stuff, wasn't scared of nothing neither. Didn't come in this world to be no slave, and wasn't gonna stay one either. That's right.
I was scared to go across the bridge.
bridge. She went all the way north. Now we will head back to the stage for our third vignette. Rosa Parks rides the bus. We all know Rosa. Rosa Parks is known as the mother of the civil rights movement because her actions on a bus caused the beginning of many African Americans standing up for their rights. Rosa Parks was well known for saying, "I believe we are here on the planet to live, grow up, and do what we can to make this world a better place for all people to enjoy freedom. I'm glad I can make a difference." She most certainly did. I'm sure we'll all agree, she most certainly did. She showed how others could stand up for something that they believed in for themselves, for others, and for the future. Sing a song about Rosa Parks. give them another round of applause. You did an excellent job with very little practice. Trust me, very little. We've been out with a lot of snow. Our final vignette now focuses on Martin Luther King Jr. He was a leader in the civil rights movement known for peaceful protests. He met and encouraged many African American families to stand against the unfair laws and to peacefully fight for changes. This final vignette, Speaking Out for Justice, focuses on two families as they travel to Washington, D.C. to witness Martin Luther King Jr. speak during the March on Washington.
It is the summer of 1963. In some places of the country, African Americans do not have equal rights.
They cannot drink from the same water fountains, go to the same schools, or eat in the same restaurants as white Americans.
In some places, they're not allowed to vote. Many people feel this is not fair.
Many people are working to make a change.
On August 28, 1963, more than 250,000 people marched to Washington, D.C. to support for equal rights.
Changes for all of us.
I agree, Lily. It isn't fair. But you remember this. Every
are not there, we are keeping the memory of the Reverend King alive. He had a dream.
They wanted for everyone to be treated fairly as we go about our days each and every day. At our schools and in our communities, let us remember to focus on how we treat others. Are we helping the dreams of these great leaders come true? We want to take this time to thank all the students and parents who made all this happen. A huge thank you to Mrs. Broadwater, Mrs. Carter, and definitely Ms. Lang. You guys worked really hard to put all this together. We really appreciate all your hard work. You ladies are amazing.
Lewis, our MC, give her a round of applause. She's really great.
Thank you for coming, ladies and gentlemen, and we hope you enjoyed the show
tonight. Thank you all very much for coming out.